A species is a group of living things that includes similar individuals that can exchange DNA or interbreed. Hybrid animals, on the other hand, are generally the result of mating between two comparable creatures, such as lions and tigers. Lab hybrid animals also exist. Somatic hybridization is the process by which scientists combine genes from both parents to create new species with useful characteristics. Because the offspring of two distinct species are usually infertile, they are not able to reproduce naturally. Nevertheless, there are some exceptions. In this video, we are going to show you some animal hybrids you will not believe ever existed in this world. But before we do that, please first subscribe to Unimaginable if you have not already, and also do press the bell icon if you love watching unimaginable things in this world. You have probably heard about the most frequent animal hybrid between a female horse and a male donkey, known as a mule. But did you realize there are other hybrids out there? Despite the fact that this sort of species crossing does not usually take place in nature, we now have zonkeys, ligers, and zebroid thanks to human intervention. These creatures are generally infertile, with certain exceptions, such as the coy wolf, which is formed by combining a coyote and wolf. Though the internet is full of Photoshop images of strange creatures, this video is full of absolutely real and amazing animals. So without any further delay, here are the top 12 animal hybrids you will not believe ever existed in this world. Number 12. Geep. The geep, a charming cross between a goat and a sheep, is one of the cutest and softest hybrid animals. Despite their adorable looks, the geep is quite uncommon. Some specialists question whether or not the geep is a genuine hybrid or simply a sheep with genetic problems. Because goats and sheep have different numbers of chromosomes, cross-species conception is virtually impossible. If it occurs, only a few newborns are carried to term, and even fewer survive birth. Because of the resemblance of the animals, it is thought that sheep-goat crossings have been taking place for a long time. Because certain primordial sheep breeds may be mistaken for goats, there exists the belief that they are goat hybrids. Number 11. Zebroid. A zebroid is a hybrid of a zebra and any equine species, technically speaking. A zebroid is created when zebra and horse are mated together. Zebra hybrids are usually infertile, and mating opportunities are few. For example, we use the term hinny to describe the progeny of a male donkey and a female zebra, despite the fact that they are quite rare. The majority of zebra hybrids have the appearance of the species they have been crossed with the exception of pure zebra hybrids who retain their striped coat. The stripes are generally limited to the legs or non-white parts of the body, depending on the genetics of non-zebra parent. Zebroids are striped like a zebra, but they resemble their non-zebra parent in terms of appearance. The stripes generally do not cover the entire body and may be restricted to the legs, or they might cover parts of the body or neck. If the non-zebra parent was patterned such as a roan, Appaloosa, pinto, piebald, or skewbald horse, this pattern may be transmitted to the zebroid via genetics. Number 10. Tigan. A Tigan is commonly confused with a liger. After all, both are mixes of lions and tigers. When a male tiger mates with a female lion, though, the offspring is a Tigan. Tigans are considerably smaller than ligers and tend to be smaller than both of their parents. They have characteristics from their lion moms, such as the ability to roar and a passion for socialization, but they resemble more towards their tiger fathers. The mane of a male Tigan is shorter and less apparent than the mane of a lion and resembles the ruff of a male tiger. It is an understandable misconception that Tigans are smaller than lions or tigers. They do not have dwarfism or miniaturization because they inherit growth inhibitory genes from both parents, but they do not grow as large as ligers. Many weighs about 180 kilograms compared to ligers weighing between 320 and 550 kilograms. It differs from the liger, which is the offspring of a male lion and female tiger. Number 9. Hulfin. The Hulfins is one of the rarest hybrid animals. They come from crossbreeding of a male false killer whale, which is a species in the dolphin family that is not related to killer whales, with a female bottlenose dolphin. Citizen Hulfin sightings in the wild are frequent, but hard evidence still eludes scientists. We can now only reliably see them in captivity. The combination of their parents is very intriguing. Their skin is a dark gray, the ideal mix of light gray dolphin skin and black false killer whale skin. They also have 66 teeth, which is the average for dolphins with 88 teeth and false killer whales with 44 teeth. The first known Hulfin was bred in a Tokyo SeaWorld in 1981. He died after 200 days. The first Hulfin to live in the United States and the first to do so was Kikamalu, who was born at Sea Life Park in Hawaii on May 15, 1985. Her name translates as from the peaceful ocean. When Kikaimalu produced a young calf, she proved capable of breeding. The youngster died shortly after birth. Number 8. Liger. The Liger is a cross between a male lion and a female tiger that produces the most well-known hybrid animal of all time. Ligers are generally much larger than either parent. The biggest non-obese Liger in the world that weighs 1,000 pounds, while the heaviest ever recorded weighed 1,600 pounds. Because lions and tigers do not typically live in the same places, finding Ligers in the wild would be nearly tough. They resemble lion cubs more than tigers, but they have tiger features such as an affinity for swimming and striped backs. The Liger has a faint tiger-like striped pattern on a lion-esque tawny background. In addition, it may also inherit rosettes from the lion parent. Lion cubs are rosetted, and some adults retain faint markings. The black and dark brown stains, as well as the sandy ones, are common. The color of the background may be tawny, sandy, or golden, depending on the subspecies. The underparts are pale in comparison to the upper side of the animal in this case, which is known as countershading. The particular design and hue depend on which subspecies your parents were and how their DNA combines in your offspring. Number 7. Green Sea Slug. The green sea slug is one of the most unusual hybrids on this list. It is a sea slug that incorporates genetic material from the algae it consumes into its own DNA as a result of natural crossbreeding. As a plant-animal hybrid that eats like an animal and creates its own nourishment by photosynthesis, it is quite unique. The green sea slug can be found in the following states: Massachusetts, Connecticut, New York, New Jersey, Maryland, Rhode Island, Florida, and Texas. They may also be seen as far north as Nova Scotia, Canada. These sea slugs are known by the scientific name of emerald green alesia. Their green color is due to their capacity to transform solar radiation into food. Scientists say that they will need to conduct further study in order to figure it out. However, until now, this has been the only effective method of gene transfer from one complex species to another. Number 6. Beefalo. Beefalo are a cross between buffalo and domestic cattle. In most situations, breeders produce beefalo by mating a domesticated bull with an American bison female. Beefalo are able to reproduce on their own, unlike many other animal hybrids, which is advantageous. Humans intentionally cross them to improve beef production and pass on the greatest qualities of both species. They have meat that is leaner, more flavorful than that of bison, but is easier to raise and more docile like domestic cattle. Beefalo are typically 37.5% bison and resemble cattle in appearance. Breeders have produced several bison/cow crosses, some of which are 50% or more bison and are known as cattalo. In addition, any hybrid that resembles a buffalo rather than a cow is usually classified as an exotic animal rather than livestock. Crossbreeding between cattle and bison has been known since at least 1749 in the southern United States during British colonization. The first intentional crossbred of cattle and bison were made during the mid-19th century. Colonel Samuel Bedson, warden of Stony Mountain Penitentiary in Winnipeg, Manitoba, initiated the first deliberate attempts to crossbreed bison with cattle in 1880. Number 5. The Cama, like the buffalo, was developed to generate a more economically viable animal than either parent. Camas are created via artificial insemination when dromedary camels and llamas crossbred. This is the ideal method of producing them since male dromedary camels weigh 6 times more than female llamas. Camas do not have camel humps, and they are covered in soft, fluffy fur similar to that of llamas. They were developed to create a massive wool-producing animal that was both strong and docile enough to be used as a pack animal in desert regions. At 4 years of age, the first Cama exhibited signs of becoming sexually mature, when he displayed a desire to breed with a female guanaco and a female llama. He was also a behavioral letdown, having an extremely terrible disposition. In 2002, the second Cama, Camala, a female, was successfully born. 5 Camas had been generated as of April 2008. Number 4. Jaglian. The Jaglian is a beautiful and intriguing big cat hybrid created by mating a male jaguar with a lioness. On the other hand, Ligars are the young of the lion and jaguar produced by couples who mate in the reverse order. It is an affix used to describe people or things related to them. Because so few Jaglian exist, little is known about them. On April 9, 2006, however, 2 Jaglian were born at Bear Creek Wildlife Sanctuary in Barrie, Ontario. Jazara female and Tsunami male were the result of an unintended mating between a black jaguar named Diablo and a lioness called Lola that had been hand-reared together and were inseparable, the one with the lion-colored coat and jaguar pattern spotting. The other, which has a beautiful jet black coat with black spots owing to the presence of the prominent melanin gene seen in black jaguars. Jaglians are a species of fairy. They have the color of lions, with lion-like rosettes, and the body structure of a jaguar. Number 3. Pisle Bears. The Pisle Bear is a hybrid between a polar bear and a grizzly bear. These creatures are also known as growler bears, and some First Nations peoples call them Nanulak, which is a blend of their words for polar bear, Nanuk, and grizzly bear, Aklak. Growler bears are significant since, in general, polar bears and grizzlies have a mutual dislike for one another and will rarely cohabit in captivity or in their natural habitats. However, extreme situations and human actions have resulted in more of these endearingly fluffy, caramel-colored mixed bears. The largest polar bear subspecies, they usually reach 60 inches tall at the shoulder and 1,000 pounds in weight. However, because of their grizzly bear ancestors, they are better able to survive in warmer climes. DNA testing was not available to authenticate the bear's ancestry in previous instances where possible wild-bred polar bear-grizzly bear mixes were detected and shot. In 2006, the existence of this hybrid in nature was confirmed by DNA testing on a distinctive-looking bear that had been shot near Sachs Harbor, Northwest Territories. The growing number of proven hybrids stems from the same female polar bear. With many possible sightings and 8 confirmed instances, theories about how such mixed would go about emerging naturally have grown increasingly speculative. Although polar bears typically live on adjacent regions, direct contact has not been typical because polar bears hunt, breed, and sometimes even make maternity dens on sea ice, where brown bears have a largely terrestrial way of life. Number 2. Savannah Cat. Savannah cats may be house pets, but they are also exotic hybrids. Savannas are striking creatures that resemble large domestic cats in size. However, their tall bodies, thin shapes, and spotted manes, on the other hand, give them a wild and exotic appear. The Savannah cat is one of the biggest domestic cat breeds. It is a cross between a domestic cat and a serval, a medium-sized, big-eared wild African cat that is classified as near threatened. During 1990s, this rare cross became popular among breeders, and in 2001, the International Cat Association accepted it as a new registered breed. TICA recognized it as a championship breed in May 2012. Savannah cats can also be taught to walk on a leash and retrieve. Some savannas are said to be sociable and friendly with people and other cats and dogs, while others may run away or hiss and growl when seeing a stranger. Savannah kittens are most likely to be sociable as they grow up because of their interactions with humans and animals. Breeders claim that around 50% of first-generation Savannah kittens develop fear and anxious behaviors when introduced into their new homes, indicating that exposure to other people and pets is a major influence in Savannah kitten socialization. These actions, if left unchecked during childhood, continue throughout adulthood. Savannah cats with greater serval blood may be up to twice the size of typical cats. As a result, anybody considering acquiring one should do considerable study. Savannah cats are highly clever, loyal, and loving animals. They are also beloved house pets. Number 1. Leapin. Leapins are beautiful and rare hybrids produced by combining a male leopard with a female lion. Leapins get to be almost as huge as lions, but they have shorter legs like a leopard. They also have leopard-like characteristics, such as a preference for water and climbing chops. A leopard is a term used to describe the offspring of a lion and a leopardess. Male lions are typically 10 feet long and weigh 500 pounds, whereas female leopards are generally only 5 feet long and weigh 80 pounds. Because there is such a large difference in size between a male lion and a female leopard, this mating is extremely rare. The first documented leapin was bred in India in 1910. It came from the hands of Walter Samuel Millard, the secretary of the Bombay Natural History Society, and was a cross between a big leopard and a lioness. Two cubs were born, one of which died at 2.5 months old, while the other lived on until 1912. Based on the data from the Japanese cats at the Nishinomiya City Zoo, leapins are larger than leopards and have characteristics from both the leopard and lioness. Brown rather than black markings distinguish them, as well as tufted tails. They may climb like leopards and appear to enjoy water, traits similar to those of the leopard. Male leapins might have sparse manes measuring 20 centimeters in length. Well, that is the end of the video. Do not forget to subscribe to the channel. See you next time.